Trump admin scores massive win with near 45-year low on unemployment claims. Labor Department statistics released Thursday shows that new weekly unemployment claims had reached a 45-year low, according to Newsmax. The numbers were apparently supported by a rebound in job growth in October after hurricane-related work issues in September. The number of state jobless claims decreased by 5,000 to 229,000. According to USA Today, that has the lowest number since 1973, 44 years ago. CNBC notes that the 229,000 new jobless claims is 2% less than the 235,000 recorded in the previous week. That wasn't the only other 40-year-old mark that the administration managed to hit. The number of Americans receiving jobless benefits was only 1.88 million, again the lowest mark since 1973. That's also a 7.9% drop over the past year. While October job numbers aren't out yet, forecasts project the United States will add 308,000 jobs, a fairly significant gain. Official numbers will be released on Friday. So, what was USA Today's takeaway on this massive win for President Trump? The weekly unemployment benefits report suggests that the economic recovery that began in the middle of 2009 is steaming ahead. Yes. Barack Obama's long game is finally paying dividends. This sounds like the same kind of obtuseness I hear when a liberal explains how Roosevelt's New Deal ended the Great Depression, which is why it only lasted until World War II. An economic recovery that takes 8 years to take hold is not an economic recovery. It's a mishandling of an economic crisis. To put it another way, would you want to be on board a ship that took 8 years to get out of the harbor, while its captain insisted it was steaming ahead? The fact is that businesses are feeling more confident with a Republican in the White House, even if that Republican is Donald Trump, a man who remains controversial among his own party and its supporters. They're also feeling more confident with the idea that tax reform is going to pass, which means more jobs. There's been a long litany of good economic news since Trump took office, most of which the president and his administration don't get credit for. Just look at the stock market, after all. Well, we're giving Trump and the GOP credit, and we hope more good news is to come.